we'll see if they want to come in. Guten Tag. Can you say that?
Guten Tag.
So, a bit away from the Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Wow, I got three of the pictures because...
Gerhard, you've been back to school today to speak to some of the children in German and English. How much have you enjoyed it?
Yeah, very much. I mean, to see the kids excited and it's just a good feeling to do something good.
How important is it, do you think, for the Swans players like yourself to come back to schools like this and give back to young fans?
Well, it's the base, isn't it? I mean, like, the supporters, you start supporting a team when you are young, most times, and our supporters at Swansea City were always been fantastic, and when I spoke to some of them, they were always saying like, "Oh, I'm with the Swans since my whole life, since 30 years, 25 years, and stuff like that." So, it's good to have supporters quite early. So.
And not only does it give them a chance to meet one of their heroes, it also helps educate them as well. How important do you think that is?
Oh, I think it's very important. Back in my time, when I was at that age, I was looking up to these stars from Bayern Munich, and I met one of them once, and I couldn't even speak to him really. I was so excited, but at the end, it's just a good feeling, and it pushes you a bit forward.
And how important do you think it is for young children to learn different languages and about different cultures?
Well, I think it is very important, but I have a different point of view. Like, you know, I think English in general is the biggest language in the world, maybe. So it's your native language, so you don't necessarily need to learn another language. But I think it's very important. I would love to speak Spanish and maybe French a bit more. So.
How was the children's German as well? You speak from the year 5s and year 6s.
Oh yeah, it's quite good. Yeah. It is a difficult language, especially at the beginning, but I think they were good.
You asked a lot of questions. What was your favourite question? Did you have a fun standout?
What's the difference between Wales and Germany?
A lot of big answer to that one.
Keep it short.
Ask your question.
How old are you?
The shape of the ball might be different, but Ryan Jones and Ashley Williams are equally comfortable in the stadium they call home. The Liberty plays host to Swansea's footballers and the Ospreys regional rugby side. Not usually at the same time, though.
Where do you sit, anyway?
There.
You sit the same pegs.
There. Where do you sit?
There. We go, well, we go 1 to 15.
But where, so where's the manager talk? There or there?
There.
See, Monk's talk's there. So we're like all this side.
So you'll go, what, 1 to 11? No,
I don't know. Ask Sue, she just jumbles it up, but I've been there for like 6 years.
The Swansea captain and the Ospreys legend are good friends outside of the arena and mutually respectful.
You know, I appreciate the sacrifice Ash has made. I just respect the job he does. Incredibly envious of what he earns, but there we are, that's a different story. But, I've got a huge amount of respect and admiration for me, because again, like everyone else who comes and turns up and watches, the millions of people who watch on TV, it's something that I can't do or couldn't do.
You always keep an eye out for the Ospreys and for Wales, obviously, and for me, I'm probably more suited towards rugby, to be honest, because I think, they're obviously big guys and they're tough men, do you know what I mean? And sometimes in football, when people are out with slight injuries, it frustrates me a little bit.
What about the fans, both inside and outside the Liberty? How do they sit as stadium mates?
Well, you'd be amazed at how many fans follow both. You know, like I came here as a Swans fan as well, and that's great. But on the flip side, at times, as rugby fans, we are policed as football fans, if you like, you know, which is more of a generic, it's far more clinical, whereas rugby traditionally has been everybody mixed together, beers in the terrace, beers in the boxes and whatnot. And I think sometimes there is a slight difference there in the feeling.
And the all-important pitch, crucial to both disciplines, but treated rather differently. Do you, when they've played a game on it, come in and think, oh my goodness, the rugby boys have been on the pitch again? I mean, you know, what have they done to my beautiful pitch?
Yeah, definitely. Look how heavy they are. They can't help themselves sliding about and doing all that nonsense.
With silly markings on it, don't you? What's that about? Push it with that one, pull it with that
and
one.
And spin it.
There you go, come on then. Look at that, you... look at that.
This family club more than benefits from a motherly touch, from a lady who looks after the kit, and a great deal more.
Everything to do with getting the footballer onto the football pitch to play the game, I'm responsible.
I'm very proud because I'm the only woman.
Some women go shopping. I do footballs and clean boots. The job is endless.
Dawn breaks over the Gower Peninsula, summoning a new working day in Wales' second city. For Suzan, the Swansea City Football Utilities Coordinator, and her assistants, including her son Michael, work starts at the training ground, preparing the kit ahead of the visit of Spanish club Valencia.
So this is our training ground, where we work every single day. So we have all age groups. First team is my priority, but we go down to the youth. This is the training room, boot room. And here's our first team changing room. And our job is to look after the first team so they want for nothing. So whether it's a pair of socks or a towel, I'm there, or the boys are there to provide it for the first team. So we start off with a t-shirt, their shorts, their jumper, trousers.
Suzan has been at the club for 17 years and has witnessed at first hand their remarkable climb from the fourth division.
When I started, we were League Two. So we were lucky to have a pair of trousers or a t-shirt. And when we'd finish in May, the apprentices used to argue to see whose first team kit they could use for the next season.
This £6 million facility is the first purpose-built training ground in the club's 102-year history and is a great marker for their success,